Hello, authors. I am here today to show you how to publish your narrative piece of writing onto our Google Classroom. So when you click on the assignment, you will see this page come up. I did put a name place for your name, so you'll go ahead and type in your first and last name. Today's date, you can type it any way you want. If you want to do the short or long way, it's up to you. And your title. Now, the story that I wrote about in my journal was about getting my puppy Hamilton. So that's what I'm going to call my story. Okay, you'll go ahead and click the enter button. You can do it one or two times. And then you're ready to start writing your story. Now, your story should already be written down in a journal or on a piece of paper. You should have edited your story, checked for spelling, capital letters, punctuation. You also could have gone back and revised your story by adding details that weren't there the first time you read it. So, once you've done those two things, which you should have done last week, you are ready to start typing your published piece. Now, I have already typed up my piece, so I'm about to just paste it here for you guys to see, and I'll kind of walk you through to make sure that you have every part of the story that you need. So here's my story. I start off with my hook. Have you ever gotten a puppy? Well, I have, and it was one of the best days of my life. Now I'm going to introduce my setting and my characters. One rainy weekend, Michael and I went over to a friend's house. Now, this was no ordinary visit because our friend's dog just had puppies. So, after I introduce the characters and kind of what my story is about, I'm going to go ahead and get started telling my story in order. Now, I'm not just going to say, first we did this, next we did this. That's when I went back and revised and I added some details that I might have forgotten. So let me see if mine makes sense. First, we arrived at our friends Livy and Chad's house. We saw the adorable puppies playing all over the living room floor. Chad and Livy were trying to give all these puppies to a good home. Oh, so I just read it and I need to add something in there that I missed. Next, Michael and I played with the puppies. They were so cute and kept nipping at our hands. Then I saw him, the chubbiest and laziest puppy snoozing under the coffee table. I just knew that squishy puppy should be ours. Last, we played with the chunky puppy for a little while and decided we would take him home. We named him Hamilton, and the rest is history. Check out my next piece called The Adventures of Hamilton. So, in my story, I included my hook. My setting and characters, my story in a sequence. I didn't just say, first we did this, next we did this. I also included details in between each part. And then I ended with a closing and kind of a hook if you want to know more about my puppy Hamilton, because now he's not a puppy anymore. He's kind of a grown up. So when you're all finished and your story looks great, it's all typed up nice and neat. If you want, with a parent's permission and supervision, you can insert a picture. So I'm going to insert a picture that I have, maybe if it'll let me. Maybe not. Let me see. Okay, so I just inserted a picture that I have of my puppy Hamilton when he was little. Looks a lot different now. If you guys want to insert a picture, you can either search for one or use one of your own if your parents know how. You don't have to add a picture, it's just something extra. And do not add a picture without an adult's supervision. But now that I'm all finished, I'm going to go back to my screen and turn in my assignment to show my teacher that I'm all ready to go. So I cannot wait to read your stories. My story was something that stood out to me from long ago. I'm wondering what your stories are all about. I hope you guys have a great day. Happy writing!